Dear students, today once again we are going to look some more important matrices. Now, in this connection, the first important matrix is idempotent matrix. The square matrix A is called an idempotent matrix if A square is A. So just to look, this is a very special matrix, and the properties of matrices, you can say, if you multiply A into A and you are getting A square. If that is equal to A, then this is called idempotent matrix. And what is a nilpotent matrix? So, a square matrix A is called a nilpotent matrix of order n. If n is the smallest positive integer, mind it. This is smallest positive integer such that A power n is equal to 0. Then in this case, this matrix is called nilpotent matrix. And what is the symmetric and skew symmetric matrices? This is also a very important matrices, and we always during the numerical computation we have to remember the definition of symmetric and skew symmetric matrices. The square matrix A is called a skew matrix if Aij is equal to Aji for every I and j. It is true for every I and j. A square matrix A is symmetric matrix if and only if transpose of A. We will look in the next PPT what is the definition. Transpose of A is equal to A. This is about the symmetric matrices. But what is the definition of skew symmetric matrices? A square matrix A is called a skew symmetric matrix if Aij is equal to minus Aji for every I and j. A square matrix A is a skew symmetric matrix if and only if transpose of A is equal to minus A. Mind it. So then in this case we call this a skew symmetric matrix. Okay. So now what is the definition of transpose of a matrix? Let A be an m cross n matrix, then the transpose of A is denoted by A power T or A dash. Sometime in some books, some teachers, some authors, they represent this as A dash or A power T is A an n cross m matrix such that, mind it, here this would be m cross n, but here n cross m matrix such that A power T ij is equal to Aji. This is ij and this is Aji. For all I varies from 1 to m and j varies from 1 to n. It means it is obtained from A by changing its rows into the columns. It is very clear here. Ij and here Aji. So into columns and its column into rows. For example, if A is the first row 1 minus 2, 3 and the second row 3, 2 minus 1. Then transpose of A is the first column, that is 1 minus 2, 3 means rows converted into the column and column into the row 3, 2 minus 1. So in this way, we can say the transpose of this matrix is this matrix. This is the order of 2 cross 3, but this the order of this matrix is 3 cross 2. Okay. Now, what is the properties of transpose? For any matrix A, if you take 2 times the transpose, then you will get the same matrix. And if the sum of A plus B power T is A power T plus B power T. But if A is matrix and K is scalar, then K multiplied by A means scalar multiplied in matrix power T is equal to K times A power T. If A and B both are the matrices such that AB is defined, then AB power T is equal to B power T into A power T. A power T means transpose of B. The A dot B, the multiplication of two matrices, their transpose is B power T, transpose of B into transpose of A. So this is about the properties of transpose. We have to remember. Okay. Thank you very much. Thank you. Stay safe. Thank you.